My dad, Tipu Doug, as you know, he's always got a story or philosophy for something. Ever since I was a little boy, I can remember coming out at 5 a.m. just to take a pee, and my dad would be already up. He'd have his legs completely stretched out. He'd have books in front of him and things highlighted while he'd be on the phone telling his guys where to go for work. But he'd be up every morning reading, and he found and learned some amazing things and took the best stuff and passed it on to my brother and I as we'd hit turbulence in our training. There's a lot of adversity that goes along with sticking with something. Me, 32 years I've been doing Kung Fu. Of course, there's times that you hit tough spots where you're wondering, or you doubt yourself, or you wonder, what the heck is the point of why? Why am I doing this? And this book is, this poem is from a book. I don't know if it's a poem or a rant, but this one hit me hard and it called me out. I think I heard it for the first time when I was about 16 or 17, and then I heard it again in my 20s, and then I just finally got my dad to pull it up and print it off, and it's gonna go into our literature and binders, but I want you guys to hear it, because it just resonates with me. It's a poem from the book, Mental Toughness. The book is called Mental Toughness. And it's written by a runner. Now, as you know, running is some of the most difficult things to do. You have to overcome a lot of pain running. Running's tough, especially being like somebody that's on a regular regimen of running. These are competitive, high-level runners, the guy that wrote this. The book's Mental Toughness to get through marathons and triathlons. This is high-level athlete stuff. It's called Why Do I Run? Why do I run? Or train. To those of you that don't run, can't understand. The pain is real every day. Is it easier now? Not really. The pain I felt the first day I began. Only easier to cover greater distances when I run. But the pain is still there. And I understand that the pain will always be there. I dread it. And in a sense, I crave it. Why do I run? To stay in shape or to keep in good health? To feel better? All partial reasons, I suppose. But I think the real reason is confirmation. Confirmation that I am in control. Every day I must make a choice. A choice to experience pain and discomfort in order to achieve a higher goal. Or to give in to the body's urging to do something else more comforting and pleasurable. Who is in control? My body or me? Every time I run, I verify to me that I am in control, that I can be the master of my own destiny. That is ultimately why I run. I feel guilty when I don't run. When my body wins, running is a test of my strength, not just my physical, but my mental strength. Running is a challenge of my will, or mind over matter, of me against myself. Training is mental conditioning, as well as physical. It's therapy for will. Each running session is a success, the richest, most deeply satisfying, strangely but unmistakably tied to self-discipline, self-denial, and self-control. In a world where I often feel helpless, victimized, controlled, running helps renew feelings of hope, strength, and conviction that I can make a difference and I can be responsible for me. An addiction or a choice, you say? And you are right. Is it a danger? So long as I choose, the value remains true and real. As long as I control running and not running control me. Positive addiction or not, the value is in the choosing. When the choice is gone, I become controlled and victimized again. One more thing in my life that tells me that I'm not in control, that I'm simply a pawn of fate and circumstance. Why do I run? I must run as a choice. not out of necessity, or its real value, again, is gone from me. Why do I run? I run for success. Success in the ultimate contest. The contest of me against myself. It says here, the essence of this poem, the difference between successful people and others is not a lack of strength, not a lack of knowledge, but a lack of will. And that's a quote from Vince Lombardi, who is the most famous football coach of all time. And Vince Lombardi was well known for taking his teams and charging them up and overcoming odds. Vince Lombardi is one of the famous coaches. So I love this because this calls me up. This calls you up, right? I have a choice. You know, the body's survival mechanism, especially if you've had some time off, your body wants to preserve energy. Fat is energy. It wants to keep you comfortable. We have something in our brain called the limbic system. The limbic system is your survival mechanism, and that is made to keep you comfortable and safe. Your body doesn't view training as comfortable and safe. So even saying I'm going to start training today, by 12 p.m. in the afternoon, your brain will already be making excuses as to why you can't train today. By the time you get off work, you'll be so tired, you'll feel like, I'm going to start next Tuesday. Right? So, who's in control then? Your body or you? Your body is. If you allow that to happen, your body wins. So, this poem resonates with me. I'm not going to print this out and give this one to you. Just meditate on something. Something in this poem stood out to you. This will be in your binders. I wanted to hit, and it'll be at an appropriate time. But read through it when you do it, and just kind of let it resonate with you. The main message of this, okay? Thanks, guys. It's all for today. We're done.